Hi everyone, my name's Jennifer Cross and I'm here for a feminine moment with Dixie Andelin Forsyth, and we are answering questions off the closed Facebook group. So a question came in yesterday and I'll just read it to you. It's a great question. She says, I ran across a meme. Oh, she shows a meme of a woman working. She's curious to know, how can a woman maintain a sense of femininity and still inspire masculinity in her man in cases where she out-earns her husband? And should a woman consider a part-time career versus full-time? Sorry if this question's been asked already, just wonder, is it possible for a woman to inspire masculinity if she's still working in cases where she could be the primary provider too? I personally feel it is a man's duty to provide, but I realize in modern marriage, this is not the case. So what should women do, and is it even possible to maintain a marriage where the husband's income is modest compared to the wife?
Of course it is. It depends on the couple. Mm-hmm. It's one thing I've learned is it's more difficult. Difficult is not impossible, but it's more difficult. Yeah. You have to go into it with your eyes open. If you are working and earning more than your husband, for example, it depends on the man. Some men become very insecure with this, others are not. Mm-hmm. And there's a tendency too that I've noticed with a lot of us to it's easier to get kind of adopt masculine tendencies when we're involved in that. And we have to watch ourselves. The foundation part of that is you actually need to realize your need for your husband and how you need him, and make sure that you are constantly aware of your need for him, because it isn't all about money. I mean, if your husband were to die today and you made four or five times the amount of money, you'd be fine financially, but what about everything else? Do you need him? And I don't mean just to buy food or pay for housing. Do you need him? And to continue to build on that foundation and be aware of that foundation, that he knows he's needed. It's another one of those areas that feminism has kind of got us into a corner.
Yeah.
Because if men aren't needed to provide, what are they needed for? They have to feel needed. They have to feel important and invaluable. What do they do if they are not financially important?
Because I'm sure they're all wonderful love stories. So when Queen Elizabeth II, I mean, there's love stories where the woman is clearly in a more powerful position or makes more money that still can last.
Yeah, I mean, that's an interesting subject about royalty, because she didn't really have a choice. And I was thinking more of Queen Victoria, because she had a famous romance with her husband. I don't know about Queen Elizabeth, what her marriage is like. She has a long marriage. I don't know how good it is. It seems like it's okay, but I haven't really studied it that much. But Queen Victoria and Prince Albert had a famous love story. And he understood her need for him, and how, because she was in a bind. She had no choice. She was born into this. She needed to rule. And she in fact had to legally ask him to marry her. He wasn't allowed to ask her.
Yeah. So,
but he knew that was a formality that she had to.
There's a wonderful series out on her life and her relationship with him and how she managed that, called Victoria. I can't remember.
Oh, the young Victoria. Yeah. The only problem with that one, I've seen it and I've also read about her life, and they put in things in there that weren't true, and it kind of bothers me.
Oh, they do. Okay.
Yeah, like he was not. It's true that he, somebody shot at her when they were riding an open carriage, but it's not true that he got shot and nearly died. The guy was caught. He was kind of a weirdo. Mm. And he caught. So he wasn't shot. And I don't think it's necessarily true that they had some big fight. And she said, don't you ever, I can't remember what this
is. I know, you're right. Because in what I have read about their love story, there's none of that.
No, in fact, what I read is that they kind of got love at first sight, both of them, when they first met. They didn't show that in the movie.
They don't.
Maybe they did that just to create more tension in the show or something, that maybe that what really happened wouldn't have been as interesting to the audience. I don't know. But but they did have a famous romance and marriage, and that she never stopped wearing black the rest of her life after he died. And she always had his clothes laid out every day.
Yeah.
So even this stuff about her last great love affair with some Indian guy, I'm not sure that that's true. Just because he helped her doesn't mean that they had some romance.
Yeah.
I don't know that any of that's true, but the most important thing is, because none of us are royal that I know of, mm-mm, watching this, that when we work outside the home and we are the primary provider, what is your husband important for?
Mm-hmm.
How is he needed? He can't have babies. And studies have shown that even when men are, they reverse roles and men are the primary caregivers and they stay home and be the house dad or whatever it's called, they don't parent the way mothers do. Mothers and fathers parent differently, which isn't like necessarily a bad thing, but primary caregiver for a dad is going to tend to be more task-oriented.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not saying that that's terrible, but it's not a mother.
And you've said this before, I think, it's just not the optimal situation.
Not ideal.
The idea.
Not ideal, right. Because women tend to, and I emphasize tend to, it's not given in stone, but they tend to become more tough as they take on the primary provider. And men can't be mothers. So they have to be invaluable and needed in some way. If men feel like they are not that needed.
Is it emasculating then?
It can be. It depends on the woman. That's why you have to be, if you have a job that earns way more than your husband, you've got to be really careful, and you can be.
Yeah.
But don't lose this, that he knows he's needed. And just like Prince Albert knew that his wife needed him, even though she had to, Queen Victoria had to be the monarch. It was a matter of birth. She didn't have a choice. I guess she could have abdicated, but she was too conscientious for that. But so if he feels needed, it's just more difficult.
Yeah.
And certainly not, it's not the optimal scenario. But like I said in the last video, women are good at multitasking, and it can be done, but it's going to be more difficult. And you can you got to really watch it constantly. Or because you can find yourself becoming a little bit bossy, a little bit dominating, domineering, and
there was a time in my life I had to do that. I worked a job, I had to come home, and what I did was I got out of the work clothes and I got into my homemaker outfit, and the change of that helped me to change my attitude.
But and also knowing that the money in the bank account is primarily yours, or what that you have generated. And so if you think of that as ours, everything is ours. And so that when you go and say, I think I'll buy this because I've earned the money, and you don't say anything to your husband, there's a thousand different scenarios that could happen. It isn't like if you work, your marriage is going to go down the drain, or if you make more money,
it's
going to be bad. But it's more complicated.
Yeah.
And for us as women, we need to watch ourselves so that we don't pick up masculine habits that are A, not attractive, and B, don't make us happy.
Right.
You just think, what happened? I don't fall into that cycle of being a boss at work, and you come home and start bossing your family, your husband around.
Yeah.
Because you have to switch hats.
You do.
Rather than staying with the same hat all day, you got to switch hats.
Mm-hmm.
Thank goodness we're good at multitasking, but it kind of wears us out.
That takes away from the femininity is when you get worn out and you lose that feminine charm a little bit.
And so that's something that can happen your whole life. Whereas children grow up and they're gone, you could be the primary provider the whole time. And then what does your husband do when children are all grown and you're what does he do? Some men are.
In a way, I wish Bob was here. Maybe we'll ask this question over the weekend when he's around, because he would have a great answer for us. I know about, in a way, what happens to men when they do stay home and have the, working wife.
They're not mothers. They can't give birth. They've got to have.
Their natural thing. I think they would have to feel something's lacking in them. I don't
Men are about feeling competent. And Bob has said it before, men like to feel competent. And that's why when we admire them, they, like you did a great job at this. They love feeling like they're good at something. They're competent. How many men value running a home and stuff? I don't know, but not as many.
Right.
They don't tend to be as good at it because they're not as good at multitasking as we are. They tend to be one thing at a time kind of people. Mm-hmm. And it's not universal for everything, but it's, they can't switch out and be mothers.
No.
If they're not, they're fathers. And so for, it's just the bottom line again is you've got to, we can do it. It's harder.
Harder, yeah. Well, thank you for the advice. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you for watching. Please like, comment, and share. We really appreciate your participation on the group and are always looking for new topics to discuss. So thank you, Dixie.
Any questions, we're happy to help.
Bye-bye.